Hey guys, it's Nicole, and this is going to be a video on all the frequently asked personal questions that you guys ask me. So I hope you enjoy this video. The very first question that I always get asked is, why am I staring in different directions? And why are my eyes always skittish and moving around everywhere? To be honest with you, being on camera doing these videos is not very natural to me. I am a very unconfident person and I have a low self-esteem. It's always been that way through middle school, but as every year passes, I get more and more confident. My anxiety through my unconfidentness is expressed through random shots of me not looking at the camera, because as a person, I usually don't give people direct eye contact longer than 4 seconds. When I talk to my friends, doctors, colleagues, I will stare at them for a couple of seconds, then look in various directions because I am anxious, I'm thinking in my mind, are they gonna see my acne scar? Does my breath stink? Do they think I'm overweight? Just the, you know, things that run through my mind when I'm staring directly at someone. So to help me with that, I've compensated by looking in alternate directions. Is it weird? Of course, but it's something that I do. Another thing that I do, oddly, is talk very fast. In my childhood, I had a huge speeching issue. I stuttered a lot, and I had a huge lisp. I stuttered less as an adult, but the lisp still stuck. So when I am anxious or insecure about speaking in public or on camera, I talk faster, another way of compensating. As you can see, I've read my nursing psych book a lot to help me understand why I do the things I do, because I want to correct them and I want to help you guys out. So if you notice weird eye movements or me talking very fast, it's because the video you're watching is probably take 19 of a lot of takes of me stuttering and being anxious. To do one video, it usually takes me 1.5 hours. It's a lot of takes. I don't like my hair. I feel really fat. My eyes are moving around too much. I have a booger in my nose. My dogs are barking. My husband's yelling. A lot of things really go on when you're doing a video. And yes, you guys also asked me, where am I filming this video? Well, it's in my bathroom. This is a magazine rack that I got from IKEA. You know, when you do your business, you want to have a little entertainment. And you guys always ask me what this is here, and that is a poster of a Elvis Presley movie. I love Elvis Presley because he had really awesome hair. Next topic is hypothyroidism. Back to hair. My hair was a really big issue for me in middle school and high school. Tons of flakes, breakage, brittleness, very dry skin, acne, anxious, always cold. I was very, very uncomfortable in my own skin in middle school and in high school. A couple of years ago, I went to the doctor and found I had hypothyroidism. Since becoming medicated, all those symptoms have somewhat subsided, but dry skin, brittle hair, and short-term memory loss is something that I deal with. The memory loss was the most difficult thing to deal with when I was in nursing school. To read a textbook over and over and over again, to think you understood the information, to then take a test and bomb it really stressed me out. So to understand the information that you easily retain took me 3 times as much. And it was very, very stressful. And that was why nursing school was so difficult for me. This is why I have my Nurse Pro Pack and my tons of little handy-dandy, you know, notebooks, because it's so hard for me to retain and keep certain pieces of information. Not always, but certain pieces. To help with my brittle and dry hair and my crappy nails, I've been taking these vitamins. They're gummy vitamins for adults. My husband makes fun of me, but I can't take those horse pills. People with low thyroid also deal with low, I guess, eyebrow hair or eyebrow hair loss. To help facilitate the growth of my eyebrow hair, I have been using this cool item called Rapid Lash, and it's made my eyelashes grow significantly. I love this product. I don't know if you can tell, but my eyebrows look freaking awesome, and the eyelashes aren't so bad on the eyes, so to speak. Having hypothyroidism has its long-term effects as well. With having hypothyroidism, you have irregular periods, and usually people with this disorder is overweight. With those two, I was diagnosed with having PCOS, which messes with my fertility, which I'm working on now. So yes, having hypothyroid is, you know, fixable with medication, but it's not curable because the medication you have to take for your entire lifetime. So yes, it has its moments, but the most difficult that I'm dealing with hypothyroidism-wise is the crappy memory, because I'm in my RN and BSN program now, having tons of difficulty. You guys also asked what's my ethnicity and where I was born. I am African American. I was born in Central Florida, but my childhood was spent in Aschaffenburg, Germany, because both of my parents were in the military. I had German nannies, I ate lots of deviled eggs, and even as an adult, my comfort food is deviled eggs. I love them. If you guys ever invite me to a party, that's the first thing I'll be wolfing down, because I just associate deviled eggs with a really good childhood. Also in Germany, I did a little child modeling. Very weird, but I did that for a couple of months. I'll see if I can get you some pictures maybe in the next couple of weeks from my parents' house. But that's kind of me in a nutshell. Anxious. I still suffer from acne. Don't get me started. It's always around the mouth, which is even more annoying. But acne, stuttering, lisp, dry hair, eyebrow growth problems, lash problems, chubby glasses. I have so many issues, but nursing, having this community, has really built my self-esteem and my confidence, but it's not 100% there. It's gotten better over time, but not 100% there. So if you see something wacky going on in the video, just say, oh, that's just Nicole. I hope you guys appreciate this video, but if you guys have any questions or comments, as always, please put them on the bottom. I thank you for your support, your comments, you guys commenting and checking out my nursing daily tips on my Facebook page. Your support is appreciated 110%. And as always, guys, thank you for watching. Bye.